Creo que ya todos sabemos que la semana pasada vimos la situación que tuvo Chris o Eva Tyson, el mejor amigo de Mr. Beast, que fue duramente criticado y sobre todo expuesto por mantener conversaciones extrañas con chicos menores de edad, donde llegó tal punto que terminaron filtrando más de 500,000 mensajes de su antiguo servidor de Discord. Pero en esta ocasión no vamos a hacer nuevamente un video acerca sobre Eva o Chris Tyson, sino que ahora el que terminaría expuesto sería el propio Mr. Beast, ya que hace unos días un chico donde afirma ser un ex trabajador de Mr. Beast subió un video titulado "Trabajé para Mr. Beast y él es un fraude", donde actualmente ese video tiene más de 7 millones de vistas. Pero en este caso no es como en los típicos videos de ex trabajadores quejándose porque los dueños de las empresas les pusieron a trabajar horas extra y les pagaron con pizza, sino lo que muestra ese chico es que mayormente los videos de Mr. Beast son falsos, donde afirma que mayormente los participantes de los concursos de Mr. Beast no son suscriptores, sino gente local o gente relacionada con sus trabajadores. Estafas o engaños que ha hecho Mr. Beast y sobre todo en incitar a sus seguidores, donde mayormente son niños, al juego. Y entre otros puntos más, así que ¿qué pedo, banda? Soy Isra, Moreno Promedio, y acompáñenme en este video para ver un mini resumen o los puntos más importantes sobre el video de este ex trabajador de Mr. Beast y saber si esos puntos puede acabar con la misma carrera o reputación de Mr. Beast. Pero antes, banda, ya saben que me motivan bastante suscribirte a este canal todo pitero para que el Don Chuy pueda llegar a los 250,000 suscriptores y finalmente conquiste Guatemala. No olviden seguirme en mi Instagram para fotos ex Don Chuy, igual es ahí donde siempre he visto cosas o nuevo video cuando estoy en directo en mi canal de Twitch. Y para la gente que me sigue en Instagram, se ganó una foto exclusiva del Don Chuy para que lo vean acá todo bonito, todo comunista. Así que síganme, banda, tiren paro. Uno de los puntos que muestra este chico es de que Mr. Beast mayormente habla de que sus videos son 100% reales, no fake, donde menciona de que nada es escrito, ya que al planificar un video puede pasar diferentes variables o posibilidades. Y lo que muestra este chico es de que mayormente Mr. Beast se la pasa usando hasta llegar al punto del exceso de CGI.
Also, if what we had to film was scripted, you know, because what we do is non-scripted, so you have to plan for a bunch of variables that you can't control, blah, blah. If what we did was scripted, holy shit, this stuff would be easy to pump out.
Have you ever faked a video?
No. But this train track is CGI, these bus wheels are CGI, this explosion is fake, this shredder is CGI, this car is digitally lifted, this pit is fake, this guy is fake, this raccoon is a paid actor, sure, this island costs more than a dollar, this city is not abandoned, these buildings are CGI, but it's not your only way out, you can literally get an Uber to the airport for $20. That's not a lurker, it's just a guy. This whole room is fake, this contestant is an actor and a secret employee at Mr. Beast, they had him dive through this fake door twice, this line is scripted, this action is scripted, in fact, pretty much all the videos with Mac are scripted.
Creo que este punto se me hace medio absurdo, ya que todos sabemos de que el uso de CGI en los videos de Mr. Beast es para que se vean más atractivos, pero en el caso de Mac yo sí los veo como si estuvieran planeados o escritos porque te hacen ver o te quieren contar como si fuera una historia. Y aparte, en el siguiente punto este chico menciona más sobre la situación de Mac, donde este nuevo compañero de Mr. Beast no era un suscriptor random, sino se trataba de un editor de video de él y que lo metió en su video porque pues le echaba demasiadas ganas en su trabajo. Y creo que también es algo que muchos ya sabemos, pero lo que muestra este chico es de que uno de los videos de Mac, este Mac se alegra de que va a ganar 800,000 dólares y que le va a cambiar la vida, cosa que resultó ser falso, ya que Mac vive en una mansión de $1,000,000.
Let's talk about Mac for a second.
We will die. Do you understand that?
I found public records showing that Mac moved from California to Greenville, North Carolina, where Jimmy is located, back in August 2023, 2 months before he appeared as a contestant. According to a former Mr. Beast employee, this is around the time when Mac started working full-time on the editing team at Mr. Beast. Also, he didn't just move into any old house, he moved into a $1,000,000 mansion. His 6,000 square foot $1,000,000 mansion comes with a movie theater and 7 bathrooms.
What are you gonna spend the $800,000 on?
I mean, my life's changed now.
Yeah, I'm sure that $800,000 is really gonna change your life.
Max is a nice car.
Tell me, where are we right now?
We're in the place that we drove to a few minutes ago.
Max, let's cut the shit here.
What have you been doing for like the last year?
A lot of family stuff.
What kind of family stuff?
Just like, you know, playing catch with my dad, you know.
For a year? How do you make money?
Otro de los puntos que muestra este chico es de que uno de los videos de Mr. Beast donde está, creo que sobreviviendo en el mar, pues literal no están sobreviviendo ni nada, muestra unos frames donde no aparece él ni sus amigos. Y sobre todo, y creo que lo más importante, es de que Mr. Beast manipula los cronómetros y hasta las propias voces de los participantes.
During this time lapse on the fourth day of 7 days stranded at sea, you can clearly see there's no one in the shelter. These are their empty beds. But after a hard cut, magically 5 people are awake and 2 of the boys have bright yellow raincoats that they didn't have when it rained on day 2.
And that
After standing the whole night completely soaked.
You didn't spend the night soaked, Jimmy. You slept on the production yacht. It's ironic because this is one of the videos where they claim that they don't fake things.
But no, we have to be the real channel that doesn't fake things.
In this video, this wink was added in post. In fact, 58 was actually on the far opposite side of the room from 42, and he just didn't hear him. This whole revenge storyline was added in post. Multiple shots show how timers are edited in post. Timers are edited in post. Timers are edited in post. They also manipulated contestants' audio in post.
So we got 15 minutes.
In general, if anything happens last second, it's fake. Or if you can hear someone's voice but can't see their mouth, the audio could easily be added in post.
I literally think I'm gonna.
Sinceramente, se me hace muy extraño o raro que manipulen tu voz y digan cosas que realmente no dijiste. Y podemos decir que es simplemente entretenimiento, ya que ahora lo que hace MrBeast es crear historias con sus participantes. Pero también estamos de acuerdo de que la esencia de MrBeast de que mete participantes que son suscriptores reales o gente random. Pero en el siguiente punto que vamos a ver, este chico menciona de que mayormente los participantes que salen en los videos de MrBeast no son suscriptores reales, sino que los participantes son trabajadores de MrBeast o amigos o familiares. Y también no sé si han visto de que en los videos de MrBeast luego en partes pues da diferentes premios o diferentes fajos de dinero ya para que se vayan. Pues bueno, los trabajadores o los amigos de ellos son los que ganan eso, no los reales.
I mean, it's not like he's ever rigged the results of a challenge. That would be impossible because he films with hundreds of random subscribers, right? Wrong. Let's look at this video. Not only were the results of this video completely scripted, but the contestants are not random subscribers.
So many people had jobs.
Oh, that contestant had to get out for her job? I guess you forgot she's your hiring manager. I actually recognize a lot of people in this video, including Jimmy's own girlfriend. So yeah, the random subscribers you see in challenges are actually never random. They're almost always local to MrBeast, and oftentimes friends and family of MrBeast employees, or just the employees themselves. And when they do pull someone from outside of North Carolina, it's usually somebody who's in the industry, who's camera trained, who has built a following. And what's even worse is that the results of this video were completely scripted. According to a former MrBeast employee, it would have been a PR problem if the boys had won by a lot. And because so many of the female contestants were MrBeast employees who got out immediately, production stepped in to actually make the results of the challenge closer. You can actually see some of this happen on camera, like when Jimmy pays one of the boys $10,000 to leave, which is twice as much as the actual prize money.
Algo que no sabía sobre este tipo de contenido sobre concursos o juegos es de que tienen sus propias leyes o códigos, obviamente para que el juego o el concurso sea justo para todos. Pero lo que menciona este chico es de que MrBeast cambia las reglas en ciertas ocasiones donde ya no se hace justo para todos.
This is a real-time video, meaning that time elapses the same in the video as it does in real life. Now, immediately, the intro is sped up, and the timer is clearly added in post, and he clearly touches the laser here, but whatever, let's assume that it's all real-time. When he reaches the bottom floor, he has to turn these water valves. Now you can tell that these valves aren't actually connected to anything because the water flows out in an instant and it happens when he's not even touching the valve. The contestant also goes back to the first valve unaware that anything had happened and he's still able to spin it. So the valve seems to spin freely and isn't actually connected to the flow of water. So you could assume that producers might be off camera with remote switches to trigger the flow of water. And assuming they've tested this, the producers might know how long it takes for the water to clear out of the room, so they could sort of decide on the fly how many turns of the valve it takes, or just when to trigger the water in general to make the results close. And in traditional media, this kind of rigging is actually completely illegal.
On any kind of a game show where there is a prize, you have to have somebody that ensures that it's fair. They are out there essentially to make sure that we don't do something that would favor one player or one tribe.
I paid the one guy who knew how to solve them to leave.
Y creo que para terminar podría considerar de que MrBeast aplicó la típica estafa que usan en los lives de TikTok. Ya saben, el típico de solo falta una persona que entre o solo falta una persona y de ahí voy a hacer algo sumamente épico. Y en el caso de MrBeast es que en un live celebrando sus 40 millones de suscriptores, se la pasaba diciendo que si alguien en los próximos 30 segundos compra uno de sus playeras, iba a poner diferentes premios como dinero, Xbox o playeras firmadas, cosa que no hizo y lo terminó repitiendo varias veces en su live.
For those of you who are just joining, if you buy one of our limited edition 40 mil special shirts, we're celebrating 40 million subscribers with a really big video, then we will sign that shirt And some of them will get random prizes like this.
46 illegal lotteries. These lotteries are also run poorly. Multiple times they would say something like, buy in the next 5 minutes for a chance to win. And then 7 minutes later go, actually, the newest order in 30 seconds is gonna win.
In 5 minutes, we're gonna do the same thing again. We're gonna put $1,000 in a random order. Hey, Daryl, don't we owe someone $1,000?
We do.
Yeah, so, all right, so the newest order in 30 seconds, we are gonna put $1,000 in your package. We're gonna break neutral.
When there was just no way they were ever even close to losing money on this stream, in 5 hours, they gave away about $50,000 worth of stuff and sold over 50,000 t-shirts. Selling these t-shirts at $42 each, profit margin would be about $22. But even if they were making like $1 per shirt, they would still be fine. Also, by my estimates, only one in every 1,600 orders actually won a prize. And I guarantee he has real-time analytics on his laptop. He knows they make more money every time he says, oh my God, guys, we're giving away so much stuff. We're not even gonna make a profit. It's insane that he can flip these massively profitable illegal lotteries targeted towards children as an act of generosity.
Y creo que lo peor a todo eso es de que algunas de las playeras que estaban firmando ni eran legítimas, porque algunos de los amigos o compañeros de Mr. Beast hacían todas las firmas juntas.
So here's a clip of Tyler forging, or not, maybe not forging, using Mr. Beast's signature. So Tyler signs MB, which is Mr. Beast's signature. Then he covers it, signs his own initials, TC, smirks, looks around, and then quickly slides the shirt away. Could you make it any more obvious? You know, you don't accidentally have someone else's signature as muscle memory.
Hey! MB, Mr. Beast. So this is Mr. Beast's signature?
No way, this one was signed by Mr. Beast. It's just got the MB, but that means it's signed by Mr. Beast.
That's obviously his. Mr. Beast, this is so cool.
Even Tariq notices Tyler slip up and immediately looks into the camera, looks guilty, and then readjusts his body and rubs his hands together. Also, Mr. Beast said during the live stream that this is the last time he'd ever sign anything, and that was just a lie.
Lo peor de todo es la emoción de esos youtubers al grabando de no manches, la playera está firmado por Mr. Beast, cosa que no es así. Y no sé ustedes qué opinen de estos puntos, en mi opinión yo los consideré los más importantes, porque también había otros puntos de este chico que sinceramente estaban bien mafufos, como en uno donde menciona que el banner del canal de Mr. Beast que dice suscríbete por una galleta, incita o manipula a los niños a que se suscriban, pero igual este chico menciona de que el banner es en forma de broma y los niños pues no nacen con el sentido del sarcasmo, pero sinceramente se me hizo muy innecesario ese punto.
Now as adults, we can recognize that subscribe for a cookie is a joke. It's not a real offer, but again, Mr. Beast's audience is primarily children who may have authorities in their life that actually use sweet treats or video game detentions as forms of reinforcement, and you aren't born understanding sarcasm.
Pero bueno, banda, me gustaría saber demasiado su opinión respecto a este tema. Si ustedes creen que los puntos que dijo este chico podrán acabar con la carrera de Mr. Beast, personalmente yo no lo veo tanto así. Yo siento de que pues va a bajar mucho su reputación y sobre todo su veracidad en los videos, pero para terminar por completo su carrera, no lo creo. Ya saben que si se la chaquetearon con este video, pues dejen su like, y igual que me botean bastante, suscribiote a este canal todo pítero para que el Don Chuy conquiste un nuevo país. Ya conquistó Guatemala al llegar a los 250 mil suscriptores, así que ustedes elijan, pongan en los comentarios el país para que el Don Chuy vaya a conquistar. No olviden seguirme en Instagram para fotos de Don Chuy. Yo soy Israel y nos vemos otro video. Cámaras.